All right, happy Sunday, folks. What is up? Today we'll be looking at the RISC-V instruction set architecture. Instruction set architecture is just how you define the supported data types, the registers, and how the hardware and software should interact with each other. This is fully open source and should allow people to design their own processors. Currently, there is a claim that there are 10 billion cores in use, so maybe there's a billion processors that have been made using this RISC-V system. I'm not really sure. This article seems to have some doubts. But either way, it is open source and the future is 100% open source. You can see that with the models using AI and how they have been exponentially increasing in size, functionality, and usability. It's only a matter of time before pretty much everything is open source and produced by people like you and me. So let's take a look at this. Let's get it set up on Linux. I've already set it up on Windows. It's super simple. So the Linux setup is going to be a little bit more involved, maybe. So we'll do that. Let's take a look. We'll start with installing Java, which is what RARS is based on. RARS is going to be the assembler, simulator, and runtime thingamajigger. That is a pretty cool GUI that comes with a pretty cool GUI and a command line system that allows you to run the RISC-V assembly code. We'll take a look at it when it's installed. And then we'll also install RIPES, because why not? RIPES is going to simulate the computer architecture. So it'll simulate a processor and allow us to kind of visualize and run the assembly code as it would run on a processor. So two separate tools that do different things using the same instruction set architecture. So let's get to it. All right, so as always, I'm going to post this in the description, and I'll probably put this on GitHub with some files that'll help us out. But first thing we want to do is install Java. If you don't know how, or if you don't know if you have it, you can run java --version, which I have already done here. Clear that, go java --version, and we will see that we're on the OpenJDK 11.0.20. That's what we want, but you can use Java 8, 11, or 17. These have been tested and known to work with RARS, according to people at my university. So if you don't have Java, which I think you should, because the OpenJDK is a dependency for a ton of packages that if you've been following my channel, or if you're using Linux at all, you've probably had to have. But if you don't have it, there's a link here with the instruction steps. It basically comes down to updating apt and installing the default -JDK. And once you have done that, just double check that java --jar gives you okay, it's actually just one. That's always confusing. If it's one dash or two dashes, it should give you the man or whatever you want to call this. Just make sure that's all good. And if it's not, try and install it again and make sure that your java --version, this is now a --, gives you this out. Then you're good to go. All right, so you got Java installed. Java. I'm not very good. My vowel pronunciation is very varied. I apologize for that. There's something wrong with the way that I speak. I don't know. I don't know what's up with that. Anyway, so you installed Java, and now let's go ahead and install RARS. This is pretty simple as well. You just scroll down to the assets portion, which we can find somewhere in the releases section. We can go to the releases section, which is here. Click that. And this is the most recent version, 1.6. Click that and it'll open up a jar file for you. Open up the folder. And what I would do is move this to somewhere that's not in the downloads folder. I'm going to create a new folder called RARS. Go ahead and open that up and I'll put that in there. And then we will move to that folder and go ahead and click that. There we go. Now that we've moved the jar file to a location that is easy to find and hard to delete, keep it in the downloads folder. You should be deleting your downloads periodically, or at least deleting the contents of the downloads folder periodically. So leaving it there is probably not a good idea. Move it to somewhere you can find it and won't delete it. And then to run RARS, you just do java --jar and then the path. Yep, whoops, it's actually just 1J again. And then you tap complete. And there you go. On Windows, it actually gives you a little, you can just click the jar file and it'll open it up for you directly, but this doesn't work like that. So there you go. Here it is. All right. So as I said before, I'm going to put the instructions in the description, and there's also a GitHub that I've put together that just includes the .jar that is RARS, and two files that are examples, that are just example files, and then a reference folder that has the instruction set, and I'll include other useful PDFs, links, and whatnot as I find them or they are given to me. All right, so that's part one of what is going to be the series on RARS and RISC-V. Part two, we're going to go over the add and add I instructions, and we will quickly look at the J sudo instruction. Stay tuned for that. Should be out pretty soon. Peace.